Welcome. In this video, we will learn that how we can create and customize table of contents. Before we move ahead, please subscribe to the channel so that you can get the latest updates. For inserting table of contents, you have to go to Insert menu. From there, you choose Indexes and Tables, and then again choose Indexes and Tables. For creating table of content, your document must contain headings. Here I have taken classification of animals with various headings, and I will explain you that how it will work. Here I have this as heading 1, this has heading 2. Under that, we have this as heading 3 and then bear as heading 4. So in this document, I have taken 4 headings. You can take more heading styles also. You can go for heading 5, 6, 7 and so on. So here, vertebrates is heading 1, warm-blooded and cold-blooded heading 2, then mammal and birds heading 3. So for inserting table of content, I need to go to insert, and from the insert I will choose indexes and tables, and from indexes and tables I will again choose indexes and tables. Here I will keep this settings and click OK. So this is how a default table of content will be inserted. Here, this is heading 1. Under that, we have warm-blooded. Under that, we have mammals. And under that, we have bear and lion. This is how the table of content is designed. For customizing the table of content, you right-click and then select Edit Index Table. In this dialog box, you will see the preview of the changes which you are going to make over here. And we have 5 tabs: index table, entries, style, columns and backgrounds. We are going to learn them one by one to understand the customization. The first thing you will see over here is title. By default, it is table of contents. So I will make it Animal Kingdom. When I press OK, it will be updated. The next thing is protected against manual changes. Currently it is selected. If I unselect it, then I can directly make the changes over here. But when it is selected, then I cannot make manual changes. I have to go through the edit or update. Then we have evaluate up to level. So currently in this table I have 4 levels. If I make it evaluate up till 2 levels, then it will only make the table of content for heading 1 and heading 2, and for heading 3 and 4 it will not make it. So I come back and make it 3 and click OK. So I will see the heading 3 appears in the table of content. And when I make it 4, I can see the level 4 heading. So now the next one is additional styles. Before I move to the additional styles, you need to understand that by default table of content is designed to work on headings only. But if there is any other style which we wanted to include into the table of contents, then we can use additional styles. To make you understand, I just changed this warm-blooded from heading 1 to caption. This warm-blooded instead of heading 1 is converted into caption, and this warm-blooded will go when I update my index table because it is no more a heading. So I go to edit index and I choose additional styles, and then I select these 3 dots. It will open up this dialog box. And now I wanted to include this caption. So I just click on this right Now this will come in the level 1 now. I click OK and OK. You will see warm blooded now at level 1. I just go back and I move it down to one more level, that is level 2. And I say OK and OK. Now warm blooded is also included in the table of content. So additional styles is basically used when you want to include other styles in the table of content which are not headings. The next one is entries. You can decide that how these lines level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4 will look like using this structure. In this structure, the first one is chapter number, then we have entry, then we have tab stop, and then we have page number. The first thing, chapter number is not visible over here. I will explain you that how you can insert that. So what you need to do is, you just have to go to tools, outline numbering, and from there you choose number style. In the preview you will see one. And after one, I just require a dot. Again, I go to level 2. In that, again I choose number. So it says 1.1. Again, I want 1 over here. So here, the sub level is 2. I go to 3. And here, the sub level is 3. For 4, again I require numbering. And the sub level is 4 over here. When you click OK and when you update, you will see 1, under that we have 1.1, and under that 1.1, 1.1, 1.1.1 and 2. This is how they are arranged now. And if I want a space between 1 point and vertebrates, what I can do, I just have to create a space over here. Similarly, for level 2 also, I can create space. For level 3, I can create space. And level 4 also, I can create space. And when I click OK, you will see the spaces has been added. If you want to remove anything, you just have to select it and press delete key from the keyboard. So currently, I don't want these tabs for in level 1. So these tabs is basically these dots which you can see. It is aligned to the right hand side. And when I press delete, I press OK, you will see it says vertebrates, and this 2 is basically the page number, because all dots has gone. So if I want to get it back, I come over here and click tab stop and align to right and say OK. So it will come back. So currently there are no dots. The reason is I did not provide any fill character. So if I say this and say OK, so it will look like this. So that is your choice that how you want to do it. Now the next one is entries. You can style your entries from character style. I just choose this and then I go to emphasize, and from the emphasize I just choose this color, and we have fonts. If you want to change the font, you can do that also, and click OK and OK. Because I have did this setting for the level 1, so it is applied to the level 1 only. And if you want to apply this setting to level 2, you can do that also. So right now I have chosen emphasize. Now I will choose example. So in that we have this background and say OK and then say OK. So this is how you can customize your table of content. The last thing which we are going to learn in this entries tab is how to create the hyperlinks. So what I need to do is, I just need to click on this space and then click hyperlink. This LS means link start. And then I select this place and then again click hyperlink. This LE means link ended. So that means my link will start with the entries and tab stop and the page number. So all these things will be a hyperlink. So when I click OK, if you look at this, these are hyperlinks now. And when I control and click, it takes me to that place straight away. So if I wanted to make hyperlink over here, I can say this and then this. So you just need to understand the difference. Here I just started hyperlink before the entry and ended it before the tab. So that means in this case, only this return material is a hyperlink. But in this case, your return material tab and this page number is also a hyperlink. The next one is styles. So whenever you want to change the style of anything, for example, content one, you want to assign this style, some other style, then you can choose this from here, right? So level one will get this content heading style. So when I say okay, so it will be like this. Then we have columns. So how many columns you want for your table of content depends upon you. You can increase the space between these. And when you click on this, it will come like this. Then we have background. You can give it a background color. Or you can also add a image. So you have to browse the image. The image should be in your computer. And then the first type is title tile. You click on this. Second one is area. And third one is position. In position, you can position your graphic. Next important thing is that if you make any changes in your document and you want the table of content to be updated, what you need to do is you just right click and click on update index table. So for example, after bear and lion, I just add one more thing over here, dog, and set it to heading 4. You see, there is no dog over here. And when you right click and say update, the dog will appear. And if you want to remove this table of content, you just need to right click and then click on delete table index. Thanks for now. See you in the next video. And don't forget to subscribe the channel.